Hello, I'm Ishwari, and I'll be offering yoga tips for new experiences. And today we will be talking about the forward fold, Paschimottanasana. Always remember that there is a fine line between sensation and strain, and you never want to push the body further than it can go. So just enjoy the sensation and follow it when you need to. As you approach the forward fold, there's many variations that you can use. One that I really like to encourage for students is to use a prop of some sort, either a pillow or a blanket, to sit on to allow the pelvis to tilt forward so the lower back isn't rounding back. So when you sit on the prop, the spine can be long. It's great to start in Dandasana, the staff pose, with the feet flexed so you're keeping the legs engaged and you can have the hands alongside the body. So it's very common in the integral yoga practice to raise the arms up and to begin to fold forward over the legs. And you can always release the hands down. It's important to remember to keep the spine long. So instead of curling forward, it's better to be further back and have the spine long. There's also other creative ways to use props in the pose. You can approach the pose with a strap as well. Keeping the feet engaged, you can bend into the knees and strap the arch of the foot. From here, you can lengthen out the feet and move the hands closer to the feet on the strap, and then begin to pull on the strap, allowing the body to come forward this way. So if you're more of a seasoned practitioner and you find yourself easily getting into the pose, it might be nice to use one block or two on the end of the feet. So you keep the feet pressed to the block. You bring your arms up if you like to get into the pose this way, or you can simply walk out. And once you come down into the full extent of the pose, you may realize that your hands are further away from the feet. And this is a great opportunity to grab a hold of blocks and rest into the pose this way. Another option for the forward fold is to put a deep bend in the knees, keeping the soles of the feet on the earth at first, and then hugging the thighs. So you want to lengthen out the spine and hug the thighs here. And you're welcome to just stay here. This may be enough of a stretch for you. Or you can slowly start to move the feet down, keeping the chest attached to the thighs. And you can stop anywhere along the way. This is a nice progression into the pose. Eventually, you'll lift the feet, and you can continue to straighten the legs as you lower the torso further towards the earth. And then you can release the arms and simply push the torso back up. So for those with bigger bodies, a bigger chest, or if you're pregnant, widening the legs, creating room for the body to lower, and you can walk the hands out, keeping the spine long, or you can raise the arms up and lower this way, creating the space in between the legs. If you'd like a more supportive version of a forward fold, you can use the blocks by placing one block down and one block stacked over it with a bolster or pillows. And you can put these in between the legs. So the body is fully supported here. From here, you can simply walk the arms out, resting the chin or the forehead on the props or turning the head to one side. This offers a more restorative version of the forward fold with the same benefits. So when you think about Paschimottanasana, the forward fold, you want to remember that the goal isn't to get the head to the knee, but it's to get the heart to the feet. So you're not bending and curling down to reach the legs, but you're extending the heart forward towards the toes, opening the chest, lengthening the spine as you begin to progress down towards the earth. When you're in your full extent of Paschimottanasana, another way to explore the pose is to bend into one knee, straightening out the other leg, seeing if the body can release forward, and then straightening out that leg and bending into the opposite leg. This helps you explore the pose even when you're close to the legs. Another option is you can interlace the fingers, you can hold on to one wrist, and you can also interlace the hands behind the back, lifting the arms up behind you, allowing the chest to fall forward, opening up the chest, and stretching the shoulders at the same time. Make sure that if you are interlacing the hands during practice, that you switch what finger is in front, or you can lengthen the hands, clasping the thumbs together. And then slowly releasing up. After you finish a Paschimottanasana practice, it's great to release the hands into the lap, closing the eyes and feeling the sensations in the body. Thank you for joining today for Variations of the Forward Fold. I hope you have enjoyed. See you next time.